Sailor Basha. Welcome to our Marine Knowledge channel. If you are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe our channel and do not forget to press the bell button so that you will be notified if any videos which will be uploaded in our channel in future. And today our chapter, the topic that we are going to cover will be how to overhaul main engine fuel valve. So we will try to give you maximum information about how to dismantle, what are all the checks that we do when we do the overhaul of our fuel valve, how to assemble it, how to do pressure test it. And please watch the video completely and please like, share and subscribe our channel. And if you don't like any of our content, kindly put a comment on it and we will try to improve our quality and we will grow with you. Thanks for watching. Now I will show you how to dismantle the fuel valve. This fuel valve is slide type, and before dismantling the fuel valve, I will do the buffing for the nozzles. You can see lot of carbons settled over here, deposited, and I will remove the carbons by doing buffing, and then I will open it. The reason why I am doing buffing is when I am going to remove the nozzle, if there is any carbon deposit over here, it will get stuck. So if I remove the carbon, and it will be easy for me to dismantle the nozzle when I am removing it. Okay, now we can see there is no carbon deposit in the nozzle. It is free of carbon. So now I can open it. This is your tool. As I told earlier, this is your tool for holding your fuel valve. So I had fixed it in the vise. Now I had kept it. When I want to open this, the easy method is you just compress this, and I'll use the hook spanner for opening it. So all I need to do is just compress this, and hook spanner, always use this hook spanner, it should properly seated. And yeah, now we can easily open it. Yeah, that's all. Very easy to remove it. And you can see it is locked, body and the top hood is locked with a pin. So this pin should be in a good condition. It is properly in place. So no problem. I will open it now. So this is your nut. Whenever you dismantle or assemble the nut, before assembling you have to check the condition of your threads. Thread should be free of carbons. If there is any deposit of carbons, then you will find difficulty in tightening the nut. So always ensure there is no carbon deposits in your nuts. Okay.
coming out. As I said earlier, this is your non-return valve. This is your high pressure pipes. You can see when I open, I found this spring is broken. So this is the reason this injector is not performing well. You can see here, injector spring is broken. And I will keep it separately. And this is your foot piece full of oil because just we removed from the engine. So it is like this. Now, very simple. So we dismantle the fuel injector. Now we have to clean it with clean diesel oil. And then I will show you what are all the points that we need to look out when we are overhauling the valves. Diesel. So we use clean diesel oil for cleaning this. Now we will soak it for some time and then we will do the cleaning. So all we need to do is just remove all the dirt, oil and everything so that it should be clean while we are going to do the box up and while we are going to do the lapping operation of lapping for your mating surfaces. Okay, let us keep this for some time. Okay, we had cleaned everything is cleaned nicely and you can see the broken spring. For some reason it got broken, so we will change the spring also. Give it the spring somewhere here and everything is cleaned. So once you are cleaned, before lapping always do the air blow. So this is your nozzle body. In this nozzle body, all you need to check, you have to check a pin inside. That pin should be intact in place, it should not be broken because that is the pin which align your spindle guide. So that spring should be inspected whether it is in a good condition or not. It should be in place, that is the main thing. So all your mating surfaces should be free of any squaring mark or any dent, but we'll do the lapping for it. For all the lapping surfaces we use very fine lapping paste, 500 grit we will use. And this is also a matting surfaces. This one is already damaged, so we will change this high pressure pipe. And this side is okay, but the other side is damaged, so we will change this pipe. And this is another matting surface. Here also we have to do the lapping. I'll show you how to do the lapping. And this is another mating surface. Here also we have to do the lapping. And here you can see the thrust foot. Here we will do the lapping. And those are the things that we need to check. And always nozzle, you have to check the condition of your atomizing hole. The atomizing hole should not have any hairline crack, or it should not be very big in size. For that, reference will be this pin. This is your reference tool, so you have to insert that pin. If it is not going, that means your atomizer hole is okay. If the pin is going inside the atomizer, that means your atomizer hole is big, enlarged, so it is time to renew your nozzle. Yeah, this is that tool. Okay, now we will do the lapping of your nozzle body. So first I do the lapping for the mating surface. This surface will be in touch with your cylinder head. So when the nozzle is placed, it will be directly mating with your cylinder head. So this should be free of any kind of marks, dent and everything. It should be absolutely clean, absolutely lapped. So I will show you how to do the lapping of this. Whenever you do the lapping, hold the nozzle in a vise and this lapping tool.
Sir.
So So whenever you are holding your nozzle in a vise, do not forget to use a copper plate, so that if you use directly with the vise, it may damage your body. So when you use the copper plate, it will avoid damaging the valve body directly. So it will save your valve body outer side. So we'll go for lapping. So this is your lapping tool. These two tool we have to use for lapping this top surface. So I'll just clean the tool. And I'll use 500 grit paste. This is your lapping paste. So lapping paste, put somewhere here. So I'll put little drop of lube oil. Okay, this is how you have to place the lapping tool. First your outer this thing and your tool inside. So once you are done, you can use, you can turn clockwise, anti-clockwise. It should be evenly done. Once you done with your lapping, you have to check the surface. You can see the lapping is done. I will do it one more time also. This tool is to ensure our lapping tool is not falling down. Okay. Now you can see the difference. Difference before lapping, and you can see a shining on your mating surfaces. So the top part lapping is done. I'll go for the inner side lapping. Inner side lapping is to ensure this mating surface will be in this area. So there should not be any kind of dirt or any kind of dent mark, any kind of scratch mark inside this area. So that is the reason we lap this bottom side. So atomizer will be sitting here. So we will do the lapping for that also. So this is your lapping tool for doing the lapping inside the valve body. So again, same paste. Oil. So when you fix the tool will be fixed like this. You can see from here, you can see the tool will come out this way. So now all we need to do is same clockwise, anti-clockwise. You have to keep on turning. Okay, this is how you need to do lapping for the inner side of your valve body. Okay, remove it. I can do an inspection of this. Yeah, you can see. You can see the mating surface is clean. after doing the lapping. And you can see the pin also side. You can see the pin, locating pin. Okay.
Lapping always. These two areas that we need to lap. So I showed both the area. One will be for the outer and one will be for the inner. So both the lapping was done. Now we will go for the non-return valve lapping. Doing this non-return valve lapping, we use this lapping tool. I will remove this locking lever. So I will remove this. So I will remove this. Take out the lever out. Okay. Again, lapping paste on the mating surface. Put some lube oil. Okay, this is your tool. Just lap it like this. You have to lap it properly, evenly. So once you are done with your lapping, always blow air. So I'll go the lapping one more time. You can see, after finishing with our lapping, you can see the difference before and after. You can see all those fine markers gone. Okay, now we do the lapping for the other side of your non-return valve. Non-return valve lapping tool for the top side. The other one, this one is your lapping tool for the bottom side, and this will be for your top side. So again, same like, you have to lap it evenly. You should not do it unevenly so that you may not get proper lapping finish. For this non-return valve, we have to do lapping for both the sides, both the outer side, inner side and the outer side. So these two sides are the matting surface, so you have to do the lapping for it. So once you are done with your lapping, blow it.
Next, we will do for the valve cover. So first will be for this. So this is your milling tool for doing milling for this area. So this is your fuel inlet area. So you can do the milling operations with this special tool. So all you need to do is hold it here, put some oil, tighten it. Now you can this milling operation will remove any carbon deposit in the fuel inlet area. You can see, the carbon is removed. I will do one more time. Always do the milling evenly, which covers all 360 degree surface. Okay. Now you can see the surface. Now it is very clean. So I'll go for the bottom one. So now we are going to do lapping for the inside of your valve body. So this is your lapping tool. Again, the same way. Yeah, we are done with the lapping. So clean it. Blow some. Okay, the lapping and the surface is good. There is no abnormality found. I clean it again. Okay. Hello. Now I'm going to do the lapping for your high pressure pipe. Actually I'm going to change this pipe, but since I want to show you how to do the lapping, what are all the checks for this pipe, I'll do the lapping and show it to you. Same lapping paste, some oil, and do the same way. you have to use this outer lapping tool for doing this lapping. Right. And again, we have to do lapping for the other side of your high pressure pipe. Same. Lap it. Okay. So, for the high pressure pipe, you have to lap here and here, both the sides. For your valve top body, you have to do the milling over here and lapping inside the body. And for the non-return valve, both the surface 1 and 2. And for the valve body, inside and outside. And whenever you do the lapping, always check the parts visually for any damage or not. Okay, now we are done with the lapping. Lapping for the entire parts was done. And now I will show you how to open your spindle guide. So, whenever you are opening your spindle guide, never open your atomizer before opening your spindle inside. So, first I will open the spindle inside. So, just keep it in your vise and you can see this is your thrust piece, and this is your cutoff slide, and these two and your spindle guide should not be interchanged with any other parts. This should be always combined. If you want to change this all together. You cannot use new cutoff slide and spindle guide body separately. You have to change one set. So now I can remove your nozzle atomizer. So for removing this atomizer, we have a special tool. That is your remote tool for your atomizer. So whenever you are fitting the tool, ensure your holding tool is properly placed in between. It should not disturb your holding pin. This is your locating pin for your atomizer. We keep in this way. Before that, you can see. Now you can see how the tool should be placed. It should be in between the locating pin. So I put it here. You tighten and you have to open the top one. If you are doing this, it will come out. You can see, yeah. So you can see the injector, the nozzle is holded by your tool, and I can remove the nozzle out. So your nozzle is out. So we are done with removing our nozzle. So all you need to check in this spindle guide is your spindle guide should be free of any mark or something. You can see the mark over here. You can see the mark. This kind of mark is not good. And you should see there is no scoring mark here also. So since there is some mark over here, this spindle guide will get problem in opening and closing. So I will change this spindle guide with a new one. So how we need to check whether this cutoff slide is okay or not? All we need to do is clean this area properly and put some lube oil. Drop some lube oil inside here also. So now you need to drop it inside. The cutoff slide should go by itself. If it is not going by itself, then that means your cutoff slide is not okay. It is going by itself, that means your cutoff slide is okay. So it should be go easily like this. This is how you have to check your condition of your spindle guide. So if it is going by itself, then it means your spindle guide is okay to use. You can use it further also. Yeah, and other thing is, you should not use any kind of emery paper, any kind of lapping in this cutoff slide, because this is very precise. And these two are precise with each other. We cannot interchange these two. See, it is very easily going. So that means it is good to use. Never use any emery paper, never do any buffing. If you want to clean, just put some lube oil and take a clean cloth and you can remove the dirt if it is there. You should not use any kind of emery paper here. Okay. So how we need to check whether this cutoff slide is okay or not? All we need to do is clean this area properly and put some lube oil. Drop some lube oil inside here also. So now you need to drop it inside. The cutoff slide should go by itself. If it is not going by itself, then that means your cutoff slide is not okay. It is going by itself, that means your cutoff slide is okay. So it should be go easily like this. This is how you have to check your condition of your spindle guide. So if it is going by itself, then it means your spindle guide is okay to use. You can use it further also. Yeah, and other thing is, you should not use any kind of emery paper, any kind of lapping in this cutoff slide, because this is very precise. And these two are precise with each other. We cannot interchange these two. See, it is very easily going. So that means it is good to use. Never use any emery paper, never do any buffing. If you want to clean, just put some lube oil and take a clean cloth and you can remove the dirt if it is there. You should not use any kind of emery paper here. Okay. So now you must have got some idea how we need to dismantle a fuel valve, how to do lapping, what are all the checks that we need to do during overhaul of your fuel valve. So next will be our assembling of fuel valve. Okay.